Today, my girlfriend's gonna show us how to make bao buns, also known as nikuman in Japan.
Okay, let's get started.
I agreed to make the dough because it's actually really similar to pizza dough. Start with 300 grams of flour. I'm using half all-purpose flour and half bread flour. To that, we'll add a couple of teaspoons of active yeast, a tablespoon of sugar, and 200 milliliters of warm water. Mix so it comes together. Knead until it becomes a shaggy dough, kind of like this. We'll need to knead until smooth, which will take about 15 to 20 minutes by hand. So let's move it into a food processor with a dough hook. Let the machine do the work for 8 to 10 minutes. I put a little too much in the first go around, so I broke it in half and did each ball of dough one at a time. Once smooth and a little stretchy, set aside to let rise. Add a little vegetable oil so it doesn't stick, and cover with some plastic wrap. Now on to the filling, which Yuki will show us how to do. For this, you'll need a star anise pod, Szechuan peppercorns, a knob of ginger, green onions, both long and short, dried shiitake mushrooms, ground meat, in this case pork, and finally some white pepper and Chinese five spice. First, we'll need to rehydrate the shiitake mushrooms. Normally, it would take an hour or more with cold water, so let's use some hot water to speed up the process. This next technique is pretty unique. Rinse the ginger and green onion, not the unique part, hold on. Give those each a slice. Add them to a small bowl with the star anise and Szechuan peppercorns. Here's the unique part. Pour over hot water and let steep. While that steeps, let's wash the smaller bunch green onions and give those a dice. After a 15-minute steep, let's drain and discard the solids. Let's also drain the shiitake mushrooms, remove the stems, slice, and dice finely. Okay, let's put it all together. Add the meat in a large bowl, toss in the shiitake mushrooms and green onions, 3 tablespoons of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of dark soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce, a teaspoon of MSG or chicken stock, Chinese five spice, white pepper, and a drizzle of oil. Use your hands to bring it together, glove recommended. Slowly pour in the steeped water. It should come together into a paste like this. It's looking good right here, but how do we know if it's seasoned properly? Yuki has a method for that. Give it a smell. She says it needs salt. And now it's good. With the filling ready, let's get back to the dough. It's doubled in size. Wait, can I show that on YouTube? That's better. I started to roll out the dough one by one, but it was coming out a little small, so I combined both balls of dough, kneaded some more. Halfway through I got fired, and Yuki decided to take over to better show me how it's done. Roll it into a log until it's smooth. Break up the dough into little balls. Give those a roll. And smush flat. To roll them out, just roll the edges thin, making sure to leave the center thicker. Grab a spoonful of filling, pinch close with one hand towards the center, while pushing the filling in with the thumb of the other. Twist and pinch close until you have a bao like this. Set it aside on a floured tray. Continue this process until you run out of dough or filling. I jumped in and did a couple.
Oh, that's too much.
Though my tough teacher was quick to point out which ones were mine. So there we have our bao ready for the steamer. Before that, if you have any filling left, cover and refrigerate. This is great as a gyoza filling too. Check out the gyoza video for how to make those. Prepare a steamer. Make sure to steam on parchment paper or cabbage leaves so they don't stick. However, we had neither, so we just painted the steamer with a little oil. We steamed about 6 at a time. You can do less or more depending on the size of your steamer. Just make sure they aren't touching. Steam for about 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, turn off the heat. And this is the hardest part. Leave covered for at least 5 minutes.
Let's see how we did. Look how juicy it is. It's yummy. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give a like and subscribe for more.